Hi, my name is Fadlon. This time we'll create a 3D reveal logo animation with a liquid metal effect using only procedural shading. First, let's prepare the logo. Import your logo's SVG file. Select all logo layers. Enter edit mode and enlarge the logo. Add a circle curve. Change the curve resolution to 32. Convert the curve to a mesh object. Edit mode and modify the curve to create a circle logo. Shape it as you wish to make the logo look 3D. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment so that this channel can grow and produce more tutorials. Also, join my Patreon community. You can download animated logo project files and other assets. Really appreciate your support. Position all center lines of the logo to the center of the grid. This is so the mirror modifier works properly. Add a boolean and follow the settings. Select another part of the logo. Convert to a mesh object and shape it as desired. Don't focus on the modification method I used. Explore further. There may be a more efficient way. The point is, make the 2D logo 3D. This is to make the logo animation more lively. Copy the bevel modifier. Now move on to the logo text. Duplicate the text layer. Temporarily change the material. Shape the 3D text using the curve settings. By utilizing this curve setting feature, it will shorten the time in forming 3D text. Add a bevel modifier for smooth shading. Copy the bevel to all text objects. Copy all curve settings to all text objects. Slightly modify the overlapping curves. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment so that this channel can grow and produce more tutorials. Also, join my Patreon community. You can download animated logo project files and other assets. Really appreciate your support. Raise the text above the logo object and adjust it slightly. Add faces in the center of the logo circle. Now for the logo animation stage. First, add an empty sphere as a control point. Select the logo and set the parent to empty sphere. Add a camera and an empty circle as camera controls. Adjust the rotation and size, then set the camera parent to empty. Adjust the camera focal length and set the resolution format. Adjust the animation duration. I used 5 seconds. At 4 seconds, insert a keyframe at the empty location and rotation. At 0 seconds, set the location and rotation, then insert a keyframe. Adjust the graphic keyframe for smoother animation. Now we get to the core part, the procedural metal liquid effect. First, add empty plane axes as control points. Rename the layer. And set the start position of the empty control shader. Set the parent to the control object so it follows the object. Enter shader editor mode and add a shader. Rename the shader material and add a texture coordinate. Connect to alpha and target the object to the shader control. Go to viewport shading mode and add a vector math length. This will make the alpha location circular and centered in the center of the control. Add math to adjust the alpha scale. Change the math to subtract and set the value. Insert keyframes at the math values at the first and last seconds. Play to check the animation. Adjust the graphic keyframe for smoother animation. Copy the material shader to all logo objects. Add math less than to keep the alpha limit constant. Add mix color and texture, coordinates and texture noise. This is to distort the alpha boundary. Adjust the texture noise until it looks like a liquid cutout. Change the principled BSDF settings to make it look like metal. Add a color ramp and connect it to the base color. This is to adjust the blending between the metal and liquid colors. Adjust the color and test play. Go to the displacement surface shader settings and select bump. Add a bump to manipulate the surface of the liquid material. Add a map range to adjust the position of the bump. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment so that this channel can grow and produce more tutorials. Also, join my Patreon community. You can download animated logo project files and other assets. Really appreciate your support. Add multiply and texture noise to create a surface illusion. Connect and adjust the settings until the surface effect is visible. Resize the shader control to your liking. Adjust the math less than in color ramp settings. Adjust the map range again until the liquid effect fits perfectly on the edge. Test play to see the preliminary results of the animation. Adjust the position and graphic keyframes for better animation timing. Test play again to see the preliminary results of the animation. Add a color ramp, image texture, mapping, and texture coordinates. This is to add a bit of a scratchy or grunge texture. Download the texture file from textures.com and select Ferris. Follow these settings or adjust them to suit your project. Check in rendered viewport mode to see the texture details. Add brightness and contrast to emphasize the texture. Here, I'm using a small amount of texture to keep the logo from looking old. We're entering the final stage, which is lighting. Add a light area and follow the settings. Go to the node shader, use nodes, and add emission and strength 2. Adjust the lighting position and adjust it to your liking. Add a little warmth to the lighting. Add a plane to act as the floor or background. Add a material shader and RGB color to create a flat color. Duplicate the plane to use as an accent light color on the object. Follow the settings. Add a light area to act as a swipe flashlight. Follow the settings. Adjust the timing, adjust the lighting position, and add keyframes. Duplicate the lighting area and follow the settings. Test play to see the temporary results of the animation. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment so that this channel can grow and produce more tutorials. Also, join my Patreon community. You can download animated logo project files and other assets. Really appreciate your support. Hope this is helpful, and thank you.